Hello and welcome to this video tutorial. Today we're looking at creating a sort of scatter brush effect with a multicolored brush in Adobe Photoshop. What I want to be able to do is to paint this flower into a document. Now there are some limits to this. We cannot rotate the flower, but apart from that, it works reasonably well. So I have this flower isolated, so it's got a transparent background. I'm going to create a document in which I'm going to be working, 1920 by 1080. I am using RGB color mode. It is also a transparent background image. That's pretty important for the way we're working. I'm going to take this flower layer and just drop it into my working image and scale it down because it's way too big for me. I'll just place it out of the way over here. I'll add a new layer because I want to paint onto a new layer. I'm going to select the mixer brush. So underneath the brush tool is the mixer brush tool. And then I'm going to select a brush to use it with. Now, if you don't have access to a brush to use, you can always go and get the old legacy brushes. Click the flyout menu here and go down to legacy brushes. And you can restore the legacy brush set to the list of brushes. I seem to have a brush that I can use here. So I'm going to choose this soft round brush to use as my mixer brush. It's pretty big. It is too big. I'm just going to scale it down so it fits around the edge of my flower comfortably. You can do this using the open and close square bracket keys, or you can come in here and just adjust it this way. You will want to set this brush to 100% hardness. So if it was soft before, just make it hard. That's really important. We're going to sample this flower here, but because it's on a layer underneath, we need to make sure that sample all layers is selected here. We also need to make sure that in this custom area, custom is probably set by default for you, you select dry heavy load. We need to get a full load of paint, this brush, this flower as our paint onto the brush. I'm going to hold down the Alt key and click on the flower to select it. And you should see it appearing up here in this dialog. And now I can just paint it into my document. So just click to paint. You can paint it a little bit more scientifically if you go to the brushes option here. So you can spread it out. So we can spread it out. We could also use some shape dynamics. The size jitter is actually not going to work here. It just comes in at the same size, but you can change the scattering. So you could have it scatter a bit more. Let me just show you what that's going to look like. Let's add another blank layer on top of the document and let's just scatter this through. So I'm just painting and the flowers are just going in any old location. As I mentioned, this brush won't rotate, so you can't rotate the flowers around. I'm just going to take another sampling of this brush, see if I could do a slightly better job, making sure that the edges of the flowers are all there. If I want smaller flowers at this point, I can reduce the size of the brush and I will get smaller flowers. So I could paint different size flowers here by just varying the size of the brush. Now there is one more option that you may want to consider in terms of filling a document with these flowers, and that is to set this up as a pattern. So I'm going back to my original flower document. I'm going to make this into a pattern with Edit Define Pattern. I'm just going to call this Blue Flower and click OK. I'm going back to my document. I'm going to turn off all these layers. I'm going to add a new empty layer in which I can work. I'll choose Edit and then Fill. I've got pattern selected here. I'm going to click here on script and I'm going to choose random fill. And then I'm going to choose my pattern, which is going to be the last in my patterns dialog, and click OK. Now I get my random fill dialog here, and you can determine the settings that you want here. So you may want no color randomness. So I'm going to dial that back down. So the flowers are going to be applied to this document with the exact color that they originally had. I'm also going to remove any randomness of brightness, but I can adjust the scale so I can make them bigger or smaller. I can also adjust the minimum scale so they're going to have some variety, some larger flowers, some smaller flowers, and then the density. I'll just click OK and the document is filled with these flowers, not very satisfactorily. So what we would do is just undo that and go and repeat it until we get a result that we like. So here I'm going to increase the density quite a bit because I didn't get a very dense effect last time. Let's just click OK. It's getting better. It's still not there. You could also put a second layer on top of this. So you could just go and repeat the approach that you took to add another layer on top. And maybe after two or three layers, you'll have the look that you want in terms of a pattern fill of these flowers. In this case, you will notice that the flowers are rotating. So you can see here that this flower is this direction, but it's over in this direction here. So that pattern fill does rotate the flowers, but you have limited control in terms of where the flowers are actually appearing in the document. Before we finish up here, if you're interested, I have more Photoshop training at Skillshare.com. If you sign up for Skillshare, you'll get access to thousands of classes there, including over 250 of mine. In the description below is a Skillshare coupon for you, which is at least as good as the current Skillshare offer. Typically, mine will be better. Please feel free to share this coupon with family, friends, and co-workers. I hope you've enjoyed this video and learned things about Photoshop of which you were previously unaware. If you did enjoy the video, please give it a thumbs up, hit the subscribe button and the notification bell, and you'll be alerted when new videos are released. Until next time, my name's Helen Bradley. Thank you so much for joining me here on my YouTube channel.